Hi, this is Matt with AppliancePartsPros.com. Today we'll be showing you how to repair your appliance.
Remember, anytime you work on an appliance, make sure it's unplugged or the circuit breakers are off so there's no chance of electrocution.
Also make sure you turn off the dishwasher's water supply underneath the sink.
In this video, we're going to show you how to change out the Maytag dishwasher push-on retainer nut. It's going to be a very easy repair, and it should only take a few minutes to show you how to do it. If you already have one of these, great. If not, you can click on the link below or get it at AppliancePartsPros.com.
When you open up the package, you're going to get the new push-on retainer nut.
The push-on retainer nut is located on the heating element leg. The main reason to be changing it is if it's rusted or damaged. In order to get to the part, we have to pull the dishwasher out. First thing we're going to do is open up the door. And then we can use our Phillips screwdriver to take out the screws. Now that we have the screws out, we can go underneath the cabinet and remove the lines. First thing we're going to do is remove your dishwasher drain line, follow it up to wherever it goes, and remove the clamp. We're going to use a 5/16 on ours. Make sure that when you take these off, that you have some towels around. Both the water line and the drain line might put some water out. Next thing we have to do is remove the fill line. It's usually connected to the hot water tap. And of course, we already had that shut off and the power disconnected from earlier. But now we need to remove the line, and we can take it off with a 5/8 inch wrench. Now that we have the lines disconnected from under the sink, we can come over to the dishwasher and use the door to carefully pull it out. Once you get it started, you can just grab the frame and use that to pull it out the rest of the way. Now that we have the dishwasher pulled out far enough, we can access the heater element connections. Now that we're at the back of the machine, we have access to the push-on retainer nut. On this particular model, there's only one of them, and it's located on the heater element leg with the red wire attached to it. So it'll be up under this plastic nut right here. In most cases, you'd only be changing this if you're changing the heating element, but we're going to show you how to change it. In order to get the wire off, we have to take a small flathead screwdriver and reach up in here and carefully pop it off. And then we can use our 3/4 inch wrench and take off this plastic nut. Once you have it pretty loose, you can just grab it with your fingers and unscrew it. Now that we have the plastic nut out of the way, we have access to the push-on retainer nut. Sometimes they're stuck up there and you have to get a wire cutters and actually just cut them off if they're rusted or whatever. But this one's coming off pretty easy, so all we have to do is pull it down off the heating element leg. Here's the old push-on retainer nut next to the new one. If you already have one of these, great. If not, you can get it at AppliancePartsPros.com. To put the new push-on retainer on, we're going to slide it up the heating element leg just like when we took it off. And then we can put the plastic nut back on to hold it all together. Once you have the nut as tight as you can get it with your hand, we're going to grab our 3/4 inch wrench and tighten it down so we get a good seal. Once you have it tight, we can grab the red wire and reconnect it to the terminal. Now that we have the new push-on retainer nut installed, we can push the dishwasher back into the cabinet. First thing we need to do is put the lines back through the cabinet. We want to push the dishwasher in about halfway and then go underneath the sink and pull on the hoses to make sure that they're not kinked or caught on anything underneath. We can push it back into the counter. Now that we have the dishwasher all the way in, we can open up the door and use our Phillips screwdriver to put the screws back in that hold it to the countertop. With the screws in, we can go underneath the cabinets and reconnect the lines. So we're going to hook up the water line and use our 5/8 inch wrench to tighten it down. Then we can hook up the drain line back up to the air gap. All you have to do is push it on and tighten down the clamp using your 5/16 nut driver or screwdriver. Now that we have the lines reconnected underneath the sink, we can close the dishwasher door, plug it back in,
turn the water back on, and take it for a spin. Thanks for joining us for another successful repair brought to you by ApplianceParts.com. Check out our other repair videos on our site, Facebook, and YouTube.